Hi guys, welcome to my channel Farooz Happy Plate. Today we are making white chicken noodle cutlet. For this you require 1 packet of boiled noodles, 1 cup of mozzarella cheese, 1 cup of milk, 250 grams of boneless cut chicken, 1 cup of cut and chopped capsicum, 1 cup of grated carrot, around 50 to 60 grams of butter, 1 cup of corn, sweet corn, 1 cup of French beans, some salt according to your taste, 2 teaspoons of green chili paste, 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper, 1/4 teaspoon of oregano, 5 tablespoons of maida, breadcrumbs and eggs for frying. First we'll boil this chicken. We'll pressure cook it. Take very little water. Also add all the vegetables with the chicken. Add all the vegetables, capsicum, French beans, and even the corn. We have to wait till the vegetables and chicken gets boiled. Also add 2 teaspoons of green chili paste. I've added the milk into the maida and made this slurry. Make sure that the slurry is without any lumps. As well as our vegetables are boiled and also the chicken. If you want, you can shred the chicken if your pieces are big. Now take a big pan, add some butter in it, now add the all-purpose flour slurry inside the butter. Mix it well. Now you can add the stock which was left after boiling the chicken. You don't have to throw it. Make sure that your slurry does not have any kind of lumps. Now add oregano, pepper, your white sauce is ready. Now add cheese. Add generous amount of mozzarella cheese. Now add some salt according to the taste. Make sure you don't add more salt because our chicken also has salt in it. Now add all the vegetables and chicken with corn inside the mixture. Give it a good mix. Now it's time to add our noodles. Add all the noodles in the mixture. Make sure you don't take much noodles. It's just 1 packet. Give the mixture a good mix. If you feel it is very tight, or the mixture is very tight, you can add a little bit of stock in it. Now I feel I need some salt in this mixture, so I'll add some salt according to my taste. This should be the consistency of the mixture. only then your cutlets would come out in proper shape. Now remove the pan from the flame and allow this mixture to cool very properly. If you want, you can refrigerate it for some time. For making cutlets, this mixture needs to be really very
cool. Our cutlet batter is ready. Now we'll shape the cutlets. I'll grease my palms with oil. Take the batter in my hand. Shape the batter in the cutlet form. You can also make some big sized cutlets, but I think this is the perfect shape and the size as well. I have taken 2 eggs mixed with salt and pepper and some breadcrumbs. I'll dip the cutlet in the breadcrumb. I'll dip it in the egg. And I'll fry it. I have put 5 cutlets in one go in the frying pan. Now we'll flip the cutlets on the other side. They have started to turn golden brown. This is another side which is under the frying process. Keep the flame low to make 25 cutlets, but for now I have just fried 5 of them. Remaining 20 you can freeze it in the freezer. You just have to wrap the cutlets, the raw cutlets dipped in the breadcrumbs, in the cling film, and you can keep it for a month in the deep freezer. Thank you for watching my recipe. I hope you like it. If you liked it, please comment, like, share and subscribe.